Hello everyone, welcome to Under Visits. In today's video, we'll be discussing some of the hidden post-apocalypse movie gems that you need to check out on Netflix. Arrest. Post-apocalyptic movie has a proud tradition of fallen society desperate for entertainment turning to over-the-top bloodsport. And we are not just talking about Bloodsport starring Jean-Claude Van Damme, The Hunger Games, Battle Royale, The Running Man, Rollerball, the half-dozen remakes and sequels to Death Race 2000. All dystopic portrays of humanity tearing itself apart to thunderous applause. This year in 2035 and Paris is governed by corporation. As massive deregulation leads to rampant poverty and homelessness, the powers that be placate the masses with broadcast fights between chemically altered combatants, pharmaceutical companies sponsor fighters who have been subjected to extreme trial and experiments. Think UFC meets Marvel's Weapon X. When a brawler known as Ares begins to turn against him, corporate overlords, he unravels a tangled web of politics intrigue far more dangerous than he ever imagined. Cargo. Martin Freeman has shared the screen with plenty of otherworldly creatures. But have you ever wanted to see him and go up against zombies in apocalyptic Australian outback? Then Cargo is the movie for you. Don't expect something as adrenaline pumping as Black Panther, as fanciful as The Hobbit, though this is a grim, harrowing drama that has more in common with The Road than it does with the World War Z or even The Walking Dead. Freeman stars as a father desperate to care for his wife and daughter in a post-zombie apocalypse world. It isn't long before his quest stops being about finding food and supplies and starts being about finding someone to care for his child before he inevitably succumbs to the zombie virus. Doom Annihilation. Doom Annihilation serves as reboot, making more effort than its predecessor to incorporate the sort of demonic beasts and portals to hell that are the Grimm franchise trademarks. Facing off against this horde of devilish imps in space is the movie's new hero. Let Jeanne d'Arc, inspired by the success of the 2016 game series Revival and incorporating inspiration from The Terminator and Aliens, Doom Annihilation is just the right kind of low-budget yet ambitious monster action ramp to keep you bloodlust alive after you have put down your controller. Iron Sky, The Coming Race. It's a sequel that looks back at its own predecessors, a movie about all-out war with moon Nazis, and declares bigger. The planet has been decimated by nuclear war after the events of the first Iron Sky. A small society of survivors has been living in old Nazi base on the moon, but they are quickly running out of resources. With a budget provided largely by fans through an Indiegogo campaign, Iron Sky The Coming Race is targeted directly at fans of audaciously bad spectacles like Sharknado. The Bad Batch. The Bad Batch follows a young woman named Orlan as she voyages through a lawless Texas desert designated as a dumping ground for various undesirables who have been rejected from society. As she encounters a colorful kaleidoscope of dangerous characters, Arlan has to come to grips with just who she is and where her allegations lie. If the concept doesn't catch your interest, the cast almost certainly will. Supporting Suki Waterhouse's breakout leading performance are Jason Momoa, Keanu Reeves, Giovanni Ribisi, Diego Luna, and Jim Carrey.